Hello everyone, my name is Fazal. You are watching MFA Civil Engineering. Depend on the degree of dressing, the rubble masonry can be divided into various groups like dry rubble masonry, uncoarse rubble masonry, coarse rubble masonry, squared rubble masonry uncoarse, and squared rubble masonry coarse. Dry rubble masonry is the most interior type of the masonry in which either a quarry, undressed or the dressed stone are used without help of the any mortar. Bigger piece of a stone are arranged at the bottom in a such a way that these should have a minimum of void and have a proper interlocking with each other. A small piece of a stone are used at the top. These wall are generally broaded at the bottom and thinner at the top. This type of the masonry is used for the construction of a retaining wall and the boundary wall of a building at the quarry site. In uncoarse rubble masonry, stone or the rubbles are used without any dressing. Means the shape and the size of the rubble or the stone used into the masonry is not same, but it is varies. The masons select the stone at the random from the heap and lay them in a line and plumb so as to form a strong bond. Before laying the stone, all the projecting corner are slightly knocked off with a hammer. The joint are filled with the mortar by a steel travel and finished to a flush. The joint should not exceed the 13 mm thickness and the large stone are used at the corner to increase the strength. Throughout stone are also provided at interval to interlock the portion between the facing and the backing, which increase the strength of a masonry. This type of masonry afford a very rough appearance. If the wall is greater than the 0.5 meter in thickness, a line of a stone header or a throat stone overlap each other by at least 15 cm. This type of masonry is used for constructing the compound wall or a boundary wall, plinth wall and the retaining wall. In coarse rubble masonry, stone are laid in a level course. In each course, header stone of a full course height are placed at a certain interval. Each header stone has width not less than its height and inserted into the wall at least 3 times its height. Size of the stone used in a masonry are in between 50 mm to 200 mm. The stone of a equal height should be used in every course of a stone masonry and the joint are not more than 50 mm in a thickness. The stone used in between the header stone should not be smaller than the 50 mm in thickness and the header stone of a successive course should not be placed one above the other. The coarse rubble masonry is commonly used in a building construction work where the wall height is low, like residential building, public building, piers, and the abutment of a small bridges. In square rubble masonry uncoarse, the squared stone means the stone whose edge have been made roughly straight. Squared does not mean that the stone are square in a section. The stones are roughly traced and are laid at the random on their natural bed so that they are interlocked. The joint should not exceed the 13 mm thickness and the void between the stone blocks are filled with the mortar and the stone chips. This type of masonry is used for making a residential building, public building and the boundary wall. In squared rubble masonry coarse, the semi-dressed stones are used. These stones are arranged in a regular courses. Stones of a equal height should be used in a course, or two or more stones are kept above each other to make up the height of the course. The mortar joint should not exceed 13 mm and the stones used in the masonry should be uniform in the color.